Here's another mixture problem. Tina wants to mix some blackberries that cost $2.75 a pound with 2 pounds of raspberries that cost $3.50 a pound to get a mixture that costs $3.25 a pound. How many blackberries should Tina buy? All right, so obviously we don't know how many blackberries, but we do know that we're going to have, let's say, a vat of a container, if you will. We'll have some blackberries. Okay, and we're going to mix that with some raspberries. And then we'll have a big mix, right? The combined vat has the blackberries and raspberries. Imagine pouring them in to this big vat. Okay, so I'm going to write inside how many pounds we have in each vat. And underneath each vat, I'm going to put the cost per pound in cents. Now, you don't have to do it in cents. You could leave it in dollars and cents. I like to do it in cents because that way I don't have to worry about any decimal points. Just makes it a little bit easier. It's back to the days when there weren't any calculators around, when I first learned how to do these problems. Okay, so let's look at what we've got here. We have some blackberries costing $2.75 a pound, and we don't know how many blackberries because actually that's the question to the problem. So we know that's going to be a variable, so how about we just write that B is going to represent the number of blackberries, B for blackberry. Now, if you'd like, you could use any variable, any letter you want for your variable, N, X, etc. But we do know the cost of these blackberries was $2.75 a pound, so in cents, that's $2.75 for each pound of blackberries, $2.75. All right, now how about the raspberries? So let's see. It tells us that we've got the raspberries cost $3.50 a pound, right? And we've got 2 pounds. Hopefully you could still read that. So 2 pounds of raspberries that cost $3.50 a pound. So I've got 2 pounds, and it was $3.50 a pound. So in cents, that's 350. So how many pounds of berries are going to be in this mixture? I have B pounds plus 2 more pounds. I've got B plus 2 pounds total. So in other words, if I had 10 pounds of blackberries, that will give me 12 pounds in the mixture once I added the 2 pounds of raspberries. Now, what about the mixture? Do we know the cost of the mixture? Well, the cost of the mixture is $3.25 a pound. So we know this is $3.25. Let me just make sure you can see this, $3.50. Hopefully you see that. All right, now let's figure out the actual cost of each of these, let's say, containers. So I've got B pounds of blackberries. It's $2.75 a pound. So it's going to be $2.75 times each pound. So this will be $2.75 B. What I'm doing is this is the total cost of each container, right? Plus, right, next container. Well, I've got 2 pounds. It's $3.50 for each pound. So that's simply $3.50 times 2, right? And for the last one, I've got B plus 2 pounds in the mixture, and it's $3.25 for each pound. So it's $3.25 times the whole amount in the mixture. Remember to put that parentheses, B plus 2. So there is the equation that'll help us find out how many blackberries to use. All right, so now let's go ahead and solve this. 275B, I can't simplify that any further, but 325 times 2 is 700. And let's do our distributive property here. 325B plus 325 times 2 is 650. Now, we need to get the variables on one side, constants on the other. I don't like having negative numbers, so I'm going to put the variables on the right-hand side, since 325 is bigger than 275. So I'm going to subtract 275B from both sides. Hey, feel free to put this on pause and try it on your own and then unpause it and see if you get the same answer I do. So we've got that. And then we're going to also subtract 650 from both sides so that the constants are on the left side of the equation and the variables are on the right. So this gives me 50 equals 50b. Oh, isn't that nice? That's not very hard to solve. Divide both sides by 50. 1 is b, or you could write that as b equals 1. Now, what did b stand for? Look at our picture. B stands for how many blackberries in the container. Hey, that was what the original problem asked us. How many blackberries are in the container? So, I'm sorry, how many blackberries should we use? And we were trying to find that out. So we're going to use 1 pound of blackberries. Now, always check your answer. We want to make sure this is correct. So hopefully this is correct, but next is the check. All right, here was the original problem. She wanted to mix, you know, blackberries with raspberries, and we drew a little picture. And then we've just solved the equation. We found out that B was 1. So now let's draw a little picture now that we know what B is. So we've got some blackberries and raspberries to mix together. Blackberries, the raspberries. And now we know that B is 1. So if I have 1 pound of blackberries and 2 pounds of raspberries, I've got 3 pounds in the mixture. And the price is, let's put in real dollars and cents now. And let's check it out. Okay. So the question is, I have 1 pound of the blackberries, right, at 275 a pound. And how much would that be? That would be 1 pound at 275. This is going to be our check. Well, obviously, that's just $2.75. You're only buying 1 pound. And then what else do we have? We've got 2 pounds of the raspberries, or B for raspberries, and that was at $3.50 a pound. So that would be 2 times $3.50 a pound. That means we paid $7 for the raspberries. So if I bought 1 pound of blackberries and 2 pounds of raspberries, I would spend $9.75, okay? Now, is that the same as just buying all 3 pounds at $3.25? That's what you're checking out here. Well, that's whatever 3 times $3.25 is. And, oops, I see that I wrote $9.55 instead of $9.75, but of course, that was supposed to be $9.75. So it checks out, yes. I could have bought 1 pound of blackberries and 2 pounds of raspberries at the respective prices, or I could have bought 3 pounds of that mixture at $3.25 a pound and paid the same amount. So that means our answer we got up here was absolutely correct. Use 1 pound of blackberries.